In this video, I'm going to walk you through the process of setting up Discord within n8n, talking about how we set up the credentials, talking about how you set your scopes for your bot, but I'm not necessarily going to talk about how to actually set up a Discord bot. Find another video for that. I'm really just talking about the connection system and getting it here into n8n so that you can have n8n operate your Discord bot for you. All right, so what we have here, just a simple workflow, just a click trigger, and a Discord node. You find a Discord node just by clicking up here on the plus, typing out Discord. There's a Discord node. And you can set it to creating channels, deleting channels, messaging, and then member actions. All right, so first thing you need to do is you actually need to have a Discord bot. Before you're ever going to be able to create your credentials, you actually have to have the bot first. So if you don't have a bot, you come over to discord.com/developers/applications. You need to be logged into your Discord account. If for some reason you see here, it's like you need to verify your email, even though you're already like logged in to Discord, I'd recommend logging out of Discord and then logging back in on the browser, and then everything should work out. And that's kind of the issue that I had when I first was trying to get this to work. I'm like, why is it not working? Log out, log back in. It'll remove that warning, and you'll be good to go. So all you gotta do is come over here to click New Application, give your application a name. So we're just gonna call this, n8n Test App ABA, so Automate Business AI. Click the check mark by creating it. You agree to their terms. Hit Create, and you need to check that you are not a robot, you are a human, and boom. Okay, so technically speaking, your app is now created. You'll want to add an icon image. You want to make sure you have your description, any tags. You'll want this application ID in just a second. Actually, we don't care about that. We don't need that at the moment. You want your depending on how you set up your bot. This is not how to set up a Discord bot tutorial, but you want to make sure you have all your links and everything here. So what we're going to do, come over to OAuth 2. All right, we're going to click on Add Redirect. We need the redirect, so let's come back to n8n, come over to connection type. Now you have three types. You have bot token, OAuth2, webhook. I'm going to show you the OAuth2 because it's easier, to be perfectly honest. Create new credentials and bring up this window here. So here's our redirect. Click that to copy it. Come back to Discord, paste that in. All right, and then we're going to come down here. Here's our client ID. Copy that. That in there. You can come over back to Discord, reset secret. Yes, do it. So it's going to generate you a new secret ID. If you already had one, hopefully you had it saved. Otherwise, you're going to have to reset it. All right, I'm going to have to put in my password. So you put in your password, submit, and then it's going to give you your new client secret. Copy that, put that in here. All right, and then we need one more thing. We need the bot token, and I'll show you how to get that in a second. But first, what we need to do is we need to make sure that our bot is able to act like a bot. So here we're gonna click bot. And again, not a tutorial on how to actually create your Discord bot. Maybe watch something else on that. But bot permissions, it's gonna be able to send messages. I need it to view channels. What else do we need to do? I don't need it to manage anything really. Really just send messages just to test it, to show you how it works. All right. And then we go ahead and hit save. We're gonna come back over here to where it says on the left bot, click on that. You're gonna hit this reset token if this is your first time. Hopefully, if not, hopefully you have it saved, but this is gonna reset and create a bot token for us. Copy that, come over to n8n, paste this into here, connect my account. All right. Now, you're only going to be able to add your bot to servers that you have admin access to. I currently have one called the Gamerpreneur. I'm going to hit check that, what permissions, which is funny because I never set these scopes, but these may be ones you want to include. Otherwise, just authorize. It's going to ask you if you're human. Check that. And we should be good. Yeah, we're good. All right, now we come back over here, close that. I'm gonna copy this. This is my server ID number, because if you click from list at this point and you click here, is it gonna give it to you? For some reason, it doesn't give me my server. Like, I don't know why, but so I just set ID, You know, if you come over to Discord and you use your browser for it, this number right here after like channels or whatever, but before this, this right here, this is your server ID. So I'm just going to grab that, use by ID, paste in there. When I paste that in there, and it then allows me to see what my list of channels is, because again, we gave the bot the ability to see the channels. So do that. And because I'm just testing it to show that this will actually work, I'm just going to do a test message. Hello, all. You can have other options. So you can have flags and messages to reply to, text to speech if you want. Embeds is where you would input some sort of link into your messaging. So here's your URLs and the image URLs, thumbnails, videos, all that. I'm not going to do any of that. Files, you can also attach files. So say you have a workflow that you're putting into your Discord bot and you're going to post it into Discord. This would be like the binary data. So you, whatever binary data name you have, it's often named data, sometimes it's named binary. Just put that in there, but I'm not going to do any of that. I'm just going to test that this guy actually works. So let's back out for a second. I'm going to hit execute workflow. And I hear a bink from Discord. Come over here, n8n test app ABA. There's my app. It says app. Hello, all. There you go. And so that is how you can use n8n in order to be able to connect Discord, to be able to start sending messages through a Discord bot. I highly recommend watching another tutorial on how to actually set up a Discord bot properly to be able to do it. But otherwise, it should work just the same as any other n8n workflow. So you can have, you know, like I said, binary files that get downloaded and submitted into Discord. You can have AI generate your responses for you. If you set up webhooks properly, again, that's a different tutorial. You can have it respond to your users. Really cool stuff. So if you found this video helpful, make sure to subscribe to the channel, like and share the video. It really does help get this information out to everybody. And if you're interested, I have a free school community with tons more tutorials and a ton of n8n workflows, ranging from social media posting bots to business development plans to executive personal assistants and more. It's all available in my free school community. The link is in the description below. I'm Bradford Carlton. Let's automate your success together.